Anti-Semitism is an evil spirit that has been going on for ages and it's been directed against the Jewish people. Join me as we listen to Diet Eman, one of the leaders of the Dutch resistance during the Second World War, as she shares the story of the rise of anti-Semitism in the Netherlands and the events that led to the Holocaust.
Well, 59 years ago, I was arrested. But when I was 18, 19 years old, Hitler occupied whole Europe and he occupied the Netherlands. And we had very many Jewish people because in 1500 and 1600, the Jews in Spain and Portugal were all burned. So they fled and they did not go to Germany. They did not go to Austria. They came to the Netherlands because we let everybody who works and lives there is okay. So we have always many people from other countries. But then Hitler became the boss and we were occupied. And it was horrible because Hitler had one thing, that he hated the Jews. Nobody knew why, but he hated the Jews. And so, and we had so many. And Anne Frank, most people have heard of Anne Frank. She came from Germany to the Netherlands because they thought there they were safe. We had not been in a war in so many, in hundreds of years. And Germany was in many wars, and they started it mostly with France. So then we were occupied. And then Hitler started to make all his rules in our country. And we have one national thing, and that is maybe sometimes good and sometimes not good, but the Dutch are very stubborn. And we don't like to be told what we can do and what we can't do. So then they started to make all rules. We couldn't go out for curfew, and we couldn't do this. And then right away he said, the non-Jews were not allowed to visit Jews or Jews visit others. And you were not allowed into all the synagogues were burned. And oh, it was horrible.
So they started this fairly soon then, right after they came in. They just started to immediately make the separation between the Jews and the non-Jews.
And I had Jewish friends. I worked with a guy. So, and he was a friend. He played beautiful violin. And my brother played in an orchestra, cello. And I played horrible piano, but we had lots
horrible
of fun
piano.
Because
okay.
we had trios. And yes. Herman came often. And then all of a sudden, he wasn't allowed to come anymore. And we said to him, the heck with Hitler, you come? He said, no, I don't dare to. So that was the first thing. And then Hitler started in the Netherlands on the Jews. And then one time Herman, he didn't dare to come to our house. He wasn't allowed to go in many streets where there were, let's say, and there were so many rules against the Jewish people. So one day he phoned me, he said, Diet, I want to see you. And we only meet in the street where he was allowed to. And on our bikes we met. And he showed me a letter. And it was, now if you think that those Jewish people were there from 1500, 1600, they had the right to be in the Netherlands.
Right,
they were
of course.
For centuries. The family was there. His father was a lawyer. There mostly they loved to study. They were lawyers, doctors, and so. And all of a sudden, all the Jewish people, and they had lists because in the town halls was always at the time also your where you were born and whatever. But the religion was also.
So they had all of this information. They had
at their
collected
fingertips
all
who
of
were
this,
the Jews
everything.
In every city and every village.
Yeah.
So then he said, Diet, he says, we got this letter, and he showed me. And it said that during the curfew, they had to report at railroad stations. And they were only allowed to leave everything behind, except they were allowed to take a change of clothing, a fork, a knife, a spoon, and a cup, and a blanket.
And that's it?
And that was it, in a hand that they could carry. Now, just think, I mean, in our family, there are heirlooms that goes from...
Yeah, right, all the family stuff just had to drop everything and go.
Everything had to leave behind. Mm-hmm. And when I heard that, I thought, that is terrible. They have... What was their crime? Mm-hmm. This is that it's a crime. They are treated as a crime. And their crime was that they were Jewish.
Yes.
And let's face it, Jesus was a Jew.
Right, our Lord is a Jew, absolutely.
And also, if the Jewish people believe him, yes or no, in Jesus... But they were God's chosen people.
That's right, the chosen people.
And so then we felt that we had to do that and help them.
Listening to Dietz's story about the rise of anti-Semitism during the Second World War reminds all of us that evil is always around us. Even anti-Semitism today is on the rise in the world. And I think the question of what we saw in the Netherlands is also a question that we have to wrestle with today, is that if we see evil happening around us or a rise of anti-Semitism, what would we do? How would we handle the same situations that came along? Because surely Dietz's life is a reminder that what happened in the past is surely going to happen again. And her life challenges, I think, all of us to think about what we're going to do when those days come our way. You know, the great philosopher and English politician Edmund Burke said that all that is necessary for evil to triumph is for good people to do nothing. And I think as we think about anti-Semitism and evil in general, it challenges all of us that we have to stand up and do the right thing to stop evil, lest evil return and the issues of the Second World War happen again. And so Dietz was really a challenge to my life and perhaps to yours about standing up and doing the right thing as the Lord so leads and directs us.